Welcome to Legends of Sports. I'm Mr. Nobody. Yeah, that's me. And today we got an exciting show for you. We're doing it on Wendell Tyler. He scored touchdowns in Super Bowls, Pro Bowls, championship games, every kind of game you can run in. And now he can't run anymore. He's had all kinds of bionic parts put in him now and stuff so he can ride the life cycle. He can't even play hoops with the boys. But he was a stud. Wendell Tyler, let's go.
Hello, my name is Wendell Tyler. I played 10 years professionally. I played 6 years with the LA Rams and 4 with the San Francisco 49ers.
When did you start playing football?
Actually, I started playing football in Pop Warner. I played 1 year and then I got too big. I could never play a game. I didn't play until I was in high school again.
Did you always know, or when did you first know you were going to go pro?
Well, actually, my whole desire was to be a professional football player when I was a little kid. I had an idol that went to Seattle. I grew up in Seattle, Washington. I had an idol named Junior Coffee. He played for Washington University, and I used to run in the streets and say, Junior Coffee goes right, Junior Coffee goes left. So my whole desire when I was a little kid, my desire, I wanted to be a professional football player because I saw the guys with the big cars, nice, a lot of girls and a pocket full of money. That was my desire, to be a professional football player.
Did you play for the love of the game or for the money?
Well, actually, both. The most fun years I had, besides playing in the NFL, was in high school. I went to Crenshaw High School in LA and I played there 3 years. And from there I got a scholarship and I went to UCLA and I played there 4 years under Pepper Rogers and Dick Vermeil and Terry Donahue. And during those 4 years at UCLA, I had 3 different head coaches. So it was kind of a learning experience for me. So I played for the fun of it, but as you got to the pros, you know, it was a business.
What was the secret to your success?
Secret to my success is I had faith. The Bible talks about now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. I had faith to believe that I could be a professional football player, but most of all, growing up in the inner cities and going to Crenshaw High, it was a lot of athletes that had the ability but didn't have the grades or the concentration to make it to the pros or even to college. And so every time I took the field, I also played not only for myself, but also for the other guys in my neighborhood that didn't make it, and that's what kept me going.
What advice would you give to a kid just starting out?
Well, the advice I would give to the kid, I always tell my son, number one, you put God first in your life. Number two, you get a good education. And number three, you might make it to the pros.
Have you ever been hurt?
Ever been hurt? This body that you see right now is like a Humpty Dumpty put back together. I have a new hip. I had 2 dislocated shoulders, you name it, it happened to me. But most of all, I just believe in myself.
What was the most significant moment in your career?
The most significant moment in my career? It's kind of hard to say what was the most significant moment in my career, you know. I had a lot of good things happen to my career. I think when I got drafted by the LA Rams in the 3rd round, that was one of the most significant moments of my career because my dream came true. And when they told me, when I went through summer camp and when I made the Rams my first year, that was a starting point.
Who was a major influence in your life?
I think a major influence in my life was my parents and my dad. You know, my dad always, he told me that I could become whatever I wanted to become. And during high school, I had different coaches there that always believed in me and told me that, hey, you know, you can accomplish whatever you want to accomplish in life, but it's all up to you. I had a coach named Joe Womack that told me that. And, I just had, my parents was very influential to help me survive.
What was your favorite part about playing professional football?
My favorite part about playing football was getting the check.
Did you have- Did you have any superstitions?
No, I didn't have any superstitions. You know, I didn't have any superstitions whatsoever.
What do you miss the most about football since you retired?
Well, what I really miss the most, I don't really miss the game. What I really miss most, not being able to run. I can't even run right now. I go out and jog 2 to 3 miles, you know. If you're a runner and you can't run anymore, you know, that's what really tears me up the most. You know, I can't go out and play basketball with the fellas. I can't go out and, you know, compete in any sports. So I try to take it out in other business ventures. You know, I try to take that out in other business ventures.
How important is an education?
Education is the most important thing that a young man can get. Like, I have a son, he's 9 years old. And he right now, I call him the first $100 billion man, you know, that's gonna be in the professional sport. And I believe in education. You know, as I look at other athletes and other high school players, you know, everybody, they think because they have a talent, that talent's gonna take them to the next level. But without education, you can't go anywhere, you know, because to be a football player, you gotta be smart, number one. You know, ability is next thing, but you have to be smart. If you're not smart, you know, you won't be able to accomplish what you want to accomplish.
When it's all said and done, how would you like to be remembered?
Okay, basically, I think I'm remembered by all my peers and all the people around the United States and around the country as a person that gave his all in all. You know, when I stepped on the field, I might have got knocked out a couple of times, but I came back. You know, I was the type of person, hey, I'm going to give my all in all, because once the game's over, I can go to the mirror, look myself in the mirror, and say, hey, I gave my all in all for my teammates.
What are you doing now?
Right now, I live out in Lancaster, California, up in the high desert in California. I'm in the real estate business. I help other people purchase their dream homes anywhere in America. That's my philosophy. So if you see this tape and you want to buy a home anywhere in America, give me a call.